Heyo, good people, we're back again. This time it's Friday, local time, and I've been enjoying my Friday so far, relaxing and in doing other things, but I thought it was time to do another one of these episodes, and I've been thinking a bit, and it's a dangerous thing when I think, because I get ideas and such. And what I've been thinking about is what we are going to do with England, or do about England. And I've come to the conclusion that as much as I like having two crowns, I'm quite a ways off getting my second crown, my empire crown, as it were. So, you know what? Bye-bye. It's 400 prestige, but I don't care. So, that's sorted. We also need to get a hold of another county for reasons that will become abundantly clear in a little while. And the county I had in mind was this one, the county of Cornwall. I have a feeling it will free up the Duchy of Lancaster as well, but that remains to be seen. It doesn't really matter right now. The only thing that matters is we get the county of Cornwall, because I kind of want it. It's nice. It's shiny. So let's see who will join me in my attempt at getting the county of Cornwall. So this is the boring bit where we invite everybody to the plot. So I'll spend the time trying to multitask and doing this while I explain my reasoning behind wanting this county. Now the thing is, I promised somebody earlier that I was going to make a trading republic, and I'm going to come through on that. And I had thought to make it back in a backwater behind the Kola Peninsula. Which is fine. I mean, it should be able to expand out to there somehow, somewhere. But I need a duchy title to do that, and more specifically, I need the duchy of the Kola Peninsula. There is some duchy associated with it. I can't remember its name right now. Anyway, I need that one. Karelian, I think. Yeah. And in order to get that, I've sent my chancellor there to try to procure that for me. However, he's taking his sweet time, so I thought about getting a Swedish one, a Swedish duchy. But then again, going to war with Sweden just to get a duchy to create a trading republic seems a little bit silly. So yeah, that's about it. So I've decided instead I'm going to create, I went past it, didn't I? Yeah. The Duchy of Norrland. And I'm going to give this klutz a duchy title. He is ambitious, but it doesn't really matter that much. He's going to love me for giving him a duchy. That's going to stick around for a while. And besides, he doesn't have heirs and things like that. So yeah, we'll see about getting him a duchy title. So that's the second thing we're going to do. And also, now that I have destroyed this title, I'm free to get a proper heir. And that's why I destroyed it. Because the idea of having this Swedish bastard succeed me is just no. But on the other hand, this guy, you guys remember him? He is the Duke of Normandy. Now, if this pans out correctly, I hope I get to play as him. I hope I can play as him. I'm not entirely certain, but I think I should be able to play as him as soon as he's nominated. So, and that will bring Normandy back into the fold and will substantially increase Norwegian holdings. So, as soon as this guy kicks the bucket, we should be all set. Now, anything else I was going to do? I was going to revoke the County of Cornwall. I'm working on that. I'm going to make Duke of Normandy my heir. Working on that too. Destroy the Kingdom of England, and Ångermanland is going to be turned into a republic as soon as I get the money for it. And in order to create that title, I need 121 gold, which should be fine. So yeah, in order to get that going, I'm going to slow down my military build-up as well, because this is strong enough, really. Check out my army levies. Doing okay. So, let's get this show on the road. Yeah. Lower Crown Authority, being led by a certain you-know-who. Oh, no longer being led by, I guess. Poor Duke. Yeah, there you go. He even has a faction. So what do you want? You want to be charitable. That is fine. 19 in diplomacy. Who is your... Yeah, you're my... You're my great-nephew. Yeah, nice of you to join. He will back it. Everybody will back it. Thank you. So everything is moving along swimmingly. You have a new heir. Yes. I get to play some. So it's kind of sneaky, but I think it's a good plan. No, you're not getting married. You're just getting educated. Relax. You're a bit young for marriage yet. If I'm gonna keep him around, I need backstabbers. So otherwise, I could do somebody who doesn't like me who should. The Duke of Lancaster, I don't care. He's Saxon, so I'm not gonna send you there. It's probably how this Pole ended up as Swedish, isn't it? I sent him to placate someone. This count is Duke of Vestlana. Yeah, I kind of want the Duke of Vestlana to like me. Fine, go there. Go get your education on. More people being invited to the plot. Yes. There we go. I think that's enough people, actually. Wonder if he'll relent. Yeah, he's joined the Lower Crown Authority. And the independent faction? What? He's in the Lower Crown Authority, and he is also in the independence faction. That's funny. I thought you could only be in one faction at a time, but apparently you can be in more. Well, stands to reason, I guess. Never really thought about it that much. Anybody else I invited to this plot? Nope, but there's the money I need in order to fix this. So should I do that before or after? Before or after? I think I'll do it before. No, I'll do it after. I need the money just in case. So, yeah, I'm gonna go right ahead and revoke this. And then war it is. Your shameful attempt at blackmail has not succeeded. No matter how many corrupted souls you have enticed to help carry out your plan, I will not give in without a fight. What is rightfully mine is mine. Signed, Duke Haldor the First of Lancaster. Who are you, really? You're a Norwegian Catholic. Yeah. Who knew you'd be a problem? How did we come to be such... Well, you don't like the fact that I destroyed your the king title, that's fine. One of the reasons why I destroyed that king title, by the way, was... Okay, there is a 50-point penalty to all relations with de jure vassals of that kingdom. However, most of them wanted to be king of England, which was a 25-point penalty. So, really, the big penalty was just a 25... But it was a 25-point hit. And, I figured I could take that. He is old, so it's not going to stick around that long. And I get proper heir, and I can even bring Normandy into the fold. So I thought, all things considered, this was a smart move. Then war it is, and we really should pause this. King Trond the Wise has declared King Trond the Wise's war to revoke Cornwall on Duke Haldor the First of Lancaster. Okie dokie. Okay, who's leaving me now? That would be... Yeah, okay, so... and her heir is me. So it's quite the opposite. Actually, if she dies now, I get it. Oh well. Somerset. On your feet, boy. So we get to do this little song and dance again. Everybody loves watching me raise my troops, right? That's why you tune into this Let's Play. All three of you. I also realized a lot of people only watch the last episode I put out in any given batch. It's like, if I put out three episodes after each other, the first two will have one or two or three views, and the last one will have like 10. So I'm curious about that. If anybody, any of you are who don't watch all the episodes, make a note and tell me why you don't watch all the episodes, and maybe if I can do something to sort of make it... I'll either make it more interesting to watch all the episodes, or make it easier to not watch all the episodes. If you want me to put a summary in the description or something, let me know and I'll see what I can do. Yeah, so there, and there, and you guys be our strategic reserve, and go there. Any more strategic reserve I can get hold of? No. I can call up the Irish, but I'm not going to do that, because the Irish cost money. Arrows cost nothing, or something like that. Okay, what am I forgetting to do? Checking if he has any allies. That's what I'm forgetting to do. None of any concern, so I hope. My liege, tales of your misdeeds are told from Ireland to Cathay. Well, that's harsh. I have discovered a plot where Aelu de Pamplona seeks to kill Prince Paul of Norway. You want to kill my... You want to kill my heir? Why... What has he done to you? Okay, apparently I have this guy in my... Okay, I have imprisoned your son? That's rude of me. I can see why. So now you want to get even, huh? How about... Well, do I really care about Prince Paul? He will make a good vassal. He'll make an excellent vassal, even if he's Swedish. So you know what? I'm gonna tell you to. I'm thinking about imprisoning her. And the reason why I'm doing that is because you can always ransom her or release her to yeah. There we go. And then we can do this little trick. And everybody should be very happy with me. Let's see. If that I wonder if I should not do that quite as quickly. Let's see. Release prisoner, plus 10. Yep, that worked fine. Even with the destroyed title. See? That didn't really matter. It didn't matter at all. And one duke is upset with me. And he's 10, so what the hell does he know about anything? You're 10 years old! You don't know anything about anything! And you're betrothed to someone. My granddaughter, who's 2 years older than you. You should listen to her, if she likes me. If not, you should not listen to her. If she likes me, she's truthful and you should always listen to her. If she doesn't like me, she's full of lies, like all women are. I was about to say I kid all the women in the audience, but I don't think there are any, so I think this is a safe space for us guys. Could all use that, right? So, okay. I always love it when this thing... I always love it when this thing pops up and there's a scream in the background for somebody dying. Modest and humble. humble. Is that any good? Plus piety. Can make it proud or wrathful. Okay, so... Oh, wow. Wow. He is a submissive little... And, was this the guy who was kind of angry with me? I think it is. Huh. He also knows I'm dishonorable. Well, in that case, yeah, let's, we're the best of friends. Let's see, was it that guy? Vassal's opinion? No, it was not. There are quite a lot of kids in the audience, aren't there? Yeah. All the Dukes of England are babies. Might not be entirely random. Count Bjorn of... Okay, what are you doing? We're at the stage now where there's just so many plots. Who was this again? Count Bjorn. Okay. In what universe is that by the alphabet? There we go. Really? I've had one drink and I can't find this guy's plot? Try to imprison, kinda, we have 62 based on relative settling. If we fail... Oh, he's excommunicated. Okay, do I want his title? Do I care one iota? Ruthless, okay. Mighty trophy. Oh. He's been hunting. And he's wounded, he's slothful, he's arbitrary, he's humble, he's envious, he's gluttonous, he's charitable, he's excommunicated in his fortune. But I don't mind this guy, I have absolutely nothing against him. He has a sucky ear, that's about the only negative thing I can say about him, but he is 20, so that'll take care of itself, hopefully. There's plenty of... He's my kinsman. Will the Pope listen to me and lift it? Cost me 25 piety. You know what? Fine. Since you are my kinsman, I will do that. Okay. Any chance of a snoo? No. Yep. Thank you, Pope. And I think that's the end of that. So I think you guys can just go home. Yeah, more of the independence faction. That's not really that interesting. Victory! Some of his army survived. For shame. And I'm just gonna set up a small ambush so that no matter where he goes, that's gonna be that. Because really, having this small army run around the countryside telling me, oh, something's being sieged all day, is just gonna get really, really, really tiresome. Just gonna look at the stats here for a second, because... Oh, it's not paused, is it? Because I need more light infantry, I think, in order to chase down these things. But the one thing I've been wondering about is, light infantry is nice and all, and it's really good for chasing down troops that are running away. But the thing I'm wondering about is, okay, if I go to, for instance, let's see, I have a holding up here, and if I build a small stable, plus 45 cavalry, to 55 cavalry. Okay, that's great. But when I call up the force here, I can't call up just the light infantry. So I'm getting this mix. And if I could sort of when I was choosing my armies, if I could send off just the light infantry, that would be very cool. But I can't. I can sort of keep troops that don't have any light infantry in one place and then send out levies that do include light infantry, but I can't send out just light infantry. That annoys... I find that annoying. Maybe something they'll fix in a DLC, who knows. Should I charge it? No, that probably won't work. It's gonna take forever. My levies have been raised too long, and my grandson of 6 needs somebody to tutor him. So we will find someone good, and I can always use another counselor, I think. So I'm gonna use... Ooh, yes. You lovely, lovely gay man. Dude. Seriously. Yeah. How about you... And you like me. I love the fact that you like me. Sucker. Because... This is one of those guys I'm hoping will just die. Okay, this is one of those good ones. That's my... Hopefully my heir. At some point. Helge for... Yeah, he'll make an excellent king. No, he will not. And then there's this guy, who for some reason is a random third in line to the English throne, or was the third in line to the English throne or something. Ooh! Ah, the county. I don't need the county. I really don't need the county. So let it go. Get me the duchy. We have 22, this is what you do, man. I need to invite someone. Excuse me. Okay, so he called in allies. I didn't really... No. Mercenaries? Armand... Yeah, they're in Normandy, right? No, they're... What? Okay, I'm so confused now, because I didn't realize we were at war. That's how it is it? He wants Cornwall. Well, you can't have it. It's mine. So he's declared for Cornwall. So that means I'm gonna be quick about it. Yep. Yup. Just to make sure that that never happens. Gotta make damn sure that never happens. That's why we have Irish... That's why we have Irish reinforcements. Now, that's just annoying. I mean, they're missing one boat to take the whole thing. Really? Reinforce that. Okay. You have decided to institute medium crown authority. I will... Oh, you're ambitious as well. That's a nice ambitious king of Denmark. Really? Really? And you want medium crown authority in Denmark? Denmark is nothing. Ugh. You're an idiot. Go away. Because Denmark is like, what, 3 provinces? And Finland and Sweden? And also I happen to have a chunk of the southern extremity of it. Yeah, we're gonna merge those up. We're gonna go there, and you're gonna go there. We're gonna stand you down. Because the question is, should I try to destroy that Norman army, or do I not really care? I think I don't really care. Wow, you have a standing army. 500 men. A force to be reckoned with, I'm sure. If anybody's wondering what I'm doing now, I decided to reinforce this so that I can actually just charge it down because I'm tired of it. So let's see. Ooh. When did these guys get involved? They're not on my side, so I'm guessing they're against you? Dude, everybody hates you. Because now that you're without my protection, they decided to attack. I see. Oh well. Yeah, you want a fee for your own, do you? I might actually... No. You'll never get a fief. If I ever go for free investiture, you'll get a temple and you'll be happy about it. And you will learn to like it. Okay, so you guys move ashore. Ashore. And then there's you guys. And then there's you. Let's just get this done. And then you go back to Ulster. And stand down so you don't cost me an arm and a leg and all the happiness of all my vassals. You can join up and I think we'll take a chance. Keep an eye on it. There's that done. 4 more days and I will be able to charge that. There we go. 79%. And I only get that one. I think. What? Oh, there we go. Okay, hang on. You. So, who are you again? Countess of... Oh, she's his vassal. But how's that gonna work when he loses his county title? Yeah, okay. Okay. Serve the title of count. Okay. Ah, he just grabbed her title. Yep. Yeah, he usurped her title. Mm-hmm. That's not very nice. That's not very nice at all. So, I'm gonna imprison you for that. Yep. In prison. Sucker. Oh, I love it when they do that. Mm-hmm. So I remember there are lots of boats there. There are some boats there. No boats there. How many boats do I need? If I take Aurel as well, I should have enough. Yep. So you guys are back in siege mode. That is spectacular news. Vassal inheritance warning. A bishop, really? Yeah, you're about to go to the Lancaster thingy. I don't care. Because that won't be a problem for long. It seems our time is up for this episode, so should I just finish this? It'll take about 2 minutes. I love the fact that he rebelled again. Oh, that was awesome news. So let's just get this done. Merge it up and charge down the walls. And stand on the fleet, so that'll cost me money. And then there's a victory. And he's at 26%. Not gonna call in allies for this. Because I could, but I'm not gonna. My domain is too big, that's fine. Does not matter in the slightest, because I'm gonna get rid of it quickly. And there we go. Now, dude. So let's just revoke his title. Do we take the county or do we take the duchy? What happens to the duchy if I take the county? I don't know. Well, I guess we'll find out in the next episode. So yeah, cheers.